Hi everyone, and welcome to episode 5 of my Let's Build a Medieval Village series. In this episode, I'll be building in the marketplace in the very centre of the village in the Middle District. I'll be showing you how to build 3 types of stalls, the tree in the centre, and a few extra decorations too. In the next episode, I'll be building in the farming district, so be sure to leave your requests in the comments section below of what you'd like to see me build there. The most popular request will be put into a poll where you'll then be able to decide on a winning build which will be featured in the next episode. I really hope that you enjoy this video and like what I've done with the marketplace. If you haven't already, be sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so that you never miss a new video. The first thing I've done is mark out where the main path through the centre of the Middle District will go. To do this, I've picked a central point where all of the paths will meet and connected this to the main entrances. For the paths, I've tried to use quite natural shapes, so they aren't completely straight. Don't worry about getting your paths identical to mine. At the moment, these are just acting as guides. As you've just seen, I've replaced the path blocks in the lower district with a mix of stone, cobblestone, andesite, and stone bricks to create a textured stone path. This is how we'll fill in all of the paths. Now I'm marking out a rough circle around where the 3 paths meet, and this will be where the marketplace will be located. Again, the shape doesn't have to be perfect, I've just made it up as I've gone along. When you've marked out your circle shape, remove all of the dirt and fill it in with a mix of cobblestone, stone, andesite, and stone bricks to create the textured stone floor here too. The extra stone at the top is to mark out where the path to the upper district will go, to act as a guide. Here's the kind of thing that you should have so far. Try not to make it too big, I've tried not to go past the tavern or the pond on the other side. Now it's time to add the tree to the centre. To do this, mark out a cross shape using grass blocks that's roughly in the centre of the marketplace. Of course, because it isn't perfectly shaped, we can't get the exact centre, so mark out your cross roughly where you think it might be. When you've done that, add an extra layer of grass blocks going all the way around, to create more of a diamond shape now. After that, add a polished andesite stair in front of the middle block, followed by 2 stone stairs and another polished andesite stair, then repeat. It should look like this. Carry on this border of stairs around all of the grass blocks now. If you've missed any of the previous episodes, then you can find the links to all of them in the description box if you're interested. Here's what you should have so far. Now, to start on the tree, place 4 logs in the centre as shown. Then come out by a block and place another 3, so you have something that looks like this. After that, come to the top of the logs and start making some branches. To do this, we're going to add sideways facing logs, coming out and turning in some random directions, as shown. Try not to make the branches too long, just do what you think is right. Here's the kind of thing that we want to create. Now repeat this a couple more times to make some more branches on the other sides of the tree. I've made 3 branches in total. After you've made your branches, completely cover them with leaf blocks so no wood is left showing. So make sure you've added the leaf blocks on each side, above and below, to cover the branch. Do this for all of the branches. Once all of the branches are covered, fill in the spaces between them and on top of the tree to really fill it out. Try to keep the shape of the leaves looking quite natural and bushy. We don't want the tree to look square or perfectly round, it's supposed to look as natural as possible. I also did a picture tutorial of this tree design over on my Instagram, so if you'd like to check that out, then you can search my username or click the link in the description. To add a bit of final detail to the leaves, I've added a few extra around the bottom that hang down by a few blocks. This makes the tree look a lot more overgrown and natural. Now, add a couple of spruce slabs in the middle of the trunk to join the two sides together as shown. Then create some roots by adding some extra oak logs at the bottom with spruce slabs dotted around too. For some extra decoration, you can also add a leaf block or two, some grass or flowers at the bottom of the tree as well. Now, to add some lighting, remove a leaf block or two from the underneath of the tree and add an oak log there. And hang some chains and a lantern from it. You can add the leaf blocks back in, surrounding the log if you don't want it to be seen. I've done this 3 times in total, making the chain a bit longer or shorter each time for variation. If you see any parts that look a bit odd, feel free to add more or remove some of the leaf blocks until you get a shape that looks a bit more natural. And that's the tree completed. We can now start work on the market stalls. The first stall design I'm going to show you is quite a small and simple one, so I'm placing these closer to the lower district. Here I'm just tidying up the join between the path and the marketplace so that it flows a bit better. Now, for the stall, add 2 spruce fences on each side with a spruce fence gate in between. Then add an extra spruce fence on each side in front of the ones that we've just placed, so you have this. On top of the back fences, add a coloured wool block with a white wool in the middle. Then add a smooth quartz slab on top of the white wool, just like this. In front of the wall, add a spruce slab on either side with a spruce stair in the middle to create this overhang. Then, in front of the lower fences, add an upside down spruce stair on each side facing inwards. In the gap, you can add your villager workstation. I've added a composter as these are the stalls close to the lower district. Then cover up the workstation with spruce trapdoors as shown. Add a lantern and then place banners that are the same colour as the wool going around the back and sides of the stall, just like this. Then you can decorate by adding an item frame with an item to represent the stall inside, and finally you can add your villager. The villager can't get out and it can use the workstation. Now I'm repeating this stall design a few more times to start to fill in the marketplace. I've made this stall a total of 5 times, using different workstations for each and also changing the colour of the wool, but the main design stays the same. Like I mentioned earlier, I kept these smaller stalls closer to the lower district, as we'll be adding larger stalls closer to the upper district next. Now it's time to build the larger market stalls, which will be within the middle district boundary, closer to the upper district. To do this, place 2 oak logs on each side with a 3-block gap in between them. In the gap, add an upside down spruce stair on each side with a spruce fence gate in the middle. Then add a spruce fence in front of the logs. At the front, add 2 upside down spruce stairs on each side with a gap in the middle, just like this. On top of the stairs on each side, add a spruce fence. Then, using spruce slabs, create a small arch on top of these fences. You can use the graphic on screen to help you if you get stuck. Repeat this arch again at the back, directly on top of the oak logs. then add a couple of spruce trapdoors on the outer sides of the top oak log as shown. In the gap in the roof, add your alternating wool blocks, starting with your coloured block and then add in the white after, just like this. Then add a smooth quartz slab on top of the white wool blocks. And that's the main structure completed. Now, for decoration, add a lantern hanging from the middle wool block inside the stall. Then add a couple of chests on the stairs at the back. These are just for decoration as they can't be opened. Add your workstation in the gap at the front, then cover it up using spruce trapdoors, just like we did with the other stalls. Now you can add a couple of item frames with items in them to show what the stall will be selling. You can also add another on the table part for decoration. Add your villager inside, and again, it can't get out and it can use the workstation. To finish the stall off, add a banner on each side that's the same colour as the wool block. I'm now going to repeat this design 3 more times, so I have 4 of these larger stalls in total. I'm adding these next stalls by the path leading up to the upper district and also on the other side of the marketplace. The structure of these stalls is the same. All I'm changing is the colour of the wool and the banners, the workstation and the items in the item frames. On the other side of the marketplace, I've just extended it out by a few blocks so there's a bit more space to work with. Feel free to make your marketplace a bit bigger or smaller to fit around the stalls that you want to add. Just try not to make it too big as there's still builds to be added in the village. Now there's just one more type of stall to add, again it's quite a small one. So, to do this, add an oak wood on each side with a one block gap in between. Then add spruce fences on top and in front of the logs, just like this. Add a spruce fence gate to the gap, then add an upside down spruce stair on each side at the front. Add a spruce fence on top of these stairs, followed by a slab, a stair and a slab on top of this, as shown. Repeat this at the back too. Then, in the gap, add your wool, making sure the white wool is in the middle, and add a smooth quartz slab on top of it. Inside the stall, remove the white wool and hang a lantern there instead. Then add your workstation to the gap at the front and cover it up with spruce trapdoors. You may have to crouch to be able to place them. Add an item frame on the front showing what the stall will sell. Then add your villager and a banner on each side that's the same colour as the wool blocks. And that's this stall design completed. Now, in the bit of space that we have left by the tree, I'm going to add 2 more of these stalls, so there's 3 in total. These small stalls are really quick and easy to build once you know how to do it, making them great space fillers in a market like this. Now I've added all of my stalls, I'm going to add a small car in the last bit of space that I have left for some extra detail. To do this, place a temporary block, then add some spruce slabs in front of it on the top half of the block. We want the slabs to be 3 blocks across and 4 blocks long, just like this. Make sure to remove the temporary block as well. Once you've done that, add 3 spruce stairs on top of the front slabs with 2 spruce fence gates in front, just like this. At the side, add 2 oak trapdoors like this to look like wheels. Do this on both sides. After that, add some temporary blocks going along the side and add spruce trapdoors in front of them so they're easier to place. Once you've placed the spruce trapdoors, you can remove the blocks. Then add a spruce sign next to the stair at the front. Do this on both sides. Now fill in the inside of the cart with some barrels, hay bales, a chest or even a composter so it looks like it's carrying stock to sell at the markets. At the back, add a spruce plank and keep the rest clear. On top of the plank, add two spruce fences with another sticking out and hang a lantern from it. Add a spruce trapdoor on the plank and two more coming out of the slabs, so it looks like the back of the cart is open. Now, behind the cart, add a few more barrels and chests to look like they've been unloaded from it. And here's what the finished cart should look like. Now, for lighting, in the corner by the path, add a chiselled stone brick block, followed by a cobblestone wall and three spruce fences. Add two extra fences coming out in different directions and hang a lantern from them. Finally, add some spruce trapdoors on the top to finish it off. We're going to repeat this lamppost design where we have a bit of space next to the paths leading into the marketplace. If there isn't enough room, don't worry, just skip that corner and move on to the next one. I've made three lampposts in total. And here's what the marketplace should now look like. To border this off a bit, I've then created a really simple wall design using oak logs, spruce fences, and spruce slabs around the outside of the marketplace. I've placed the log followed by three fences in random directions, then another log connected to these with spruce slabs on top. I've repeated this pattern all the way around the marketplace, leaving gaps where the paths are. This just helps to bring a bit more structure to the build, so it isn't out in the open like it is at the moment. Where the cart is, I've brought the outline out a bit, so there's a bit of extra space where the barrels will be unloaded. I've also cleared out a bit of land at the back, so there's a gap here. Now, to finish off the marketplace, I've filled in any gaps that are left by the stalls with some barrels and chests to add a bit more life to the build and make it feel a bit more full and busy. Only add the barrels and chests where you feel like there's a gap. You don't have to go overboard with them. Make sure there's still enough room to easily walk through the markets. And that's the entire marketplace completed. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope that you've enjoyed this video and I can't wait to see your screenshots of this in your own worlds. If you haven't already, please leave a like and consider subscribing to see more content like this. And if you're already subscribed, be sure to hit the notification bell so that you never miss a new video.